Hi, I'm Adrian, an AI software evangelist at Intel. Today, I'm going to show you how to use the OpenVINO toolkit to build a custom AI assistant. This Edge AI reference kit contains the open source resources and corresponding guidance required to create an application that captures spoken information and synthesizes it into powerful analyses and actionable insights. We have created a sample AI assistant application that uses open source automatic speech recognition, natural language processing, and large language model tools. The app lives on our GitHub repo. It incorporates open source models that include Whisper for automatic speech recognition, Llama for large language modeling, and front-end radio interface. You can try it out by cloning the repo and running the app on your machine. We have designed this app, like all of our Edge AI reference kits, to be able to be modified or adapted by you, so you can quickly and efficiently make a powerful AI solution that meets your specific needs. This scenario we have chosen for our sample kit is medical intake. This app has been customized to gather information from a patient entering a medical clinic, and it prompts the patients to describe their symptoms, medical history, and other relevant information. And then it synthesizes this information into a detailed, annotated summary for a medical practitioner. The information generated by the AI assistant includes actionable insights to make the medical practitioner more efficient and optimize their ability to care for patients. There are a few system requirements for installing and setting up this kit on your machine. First, you must have Python 3.8 or higher, and you must gain access to Llama. You must also have bandwidth and disk space to download and run the models, at least 8 gigabytes. So, let's get started. The first step is, of course, to create an environment. So we need to clone the repository, we need to install all dependencies, we need to get the license for Llama. We need to also use that token in Hugging Face interface. All dependencies are specified in the requirements file, so we need to install OpenVINO, Optimum, Intel, NNCF, and of course you should follow the README file to achieve the same results as I did. The first script we need to run is convert and optimize ASR, which means automatic speech recognition. In this case, we will use Distill Whisper model, and this model must be downloaded and exported to OpenVINO format plus optional quantization. And this is done through the Optimum Intel, which is a wrapper for Hugging Face Transformers library. So it's super easy and with nice API of Transformers. As you can see, only about 48 lines of code here. So what we do, we load the model here. We also specify that we want to export. And if one wants to use quantization, we also add this parameter load in 8 bits. If not, it must equal false. And then we, of course, save pre-trained model to the disk to be able to use it later. And then we export also the processor for that model. And that's all. The Distill Whisper model is already exported. The second thing we need to do is to convert and optimize chat model, because we will also use a chatbot here. So the code is very similar. We also use Optimum Intel and Transformers library, and we can select one of these models, Llama 2 7 billions or 13 billions, or Neural Chat 7 billions. I will continue with Llama 7 billions here, but you can select any you want. And the code is, as I mentioned, very, very similar Of course, here we can do even more quantization. Instead of int 8 format, we can also quantize the model weights to int 4. And for that, we have additional configuration in line 35. When we have it done, quantized or not, the model is saved to disk as well to use it later in our application. And what we need to also to do here is to export tokenizer for this model to have it in OpenVINO format as well. And that's all, 65 lines of code to export chat model. Of course, when running for the first time, it will take some time because we need to download these big models from the internet. But after that, the second run, the third one, and so on, it will be super fast. And of course, you don't have to run it like every week, or every day, or every hour. It should be run just once at the beginning, and then you can use the result, the exported model in app. So let's jump to the last script, the application itself. This application is built with Gradio interface and contains a few functions, like functions to use Distal Whisper to recognize speech, a function to work with the chatbot model, and so on and so on. I'm not gonna go into much detail here because there are, you know, many functions here to load, to respond, to build the interface, and so on. I will focus just on what's important here. So, as this application is configurable, we can change the prompt, right? And this initial prompt is to instruct the chatbot to work as a healthcare assistant. But you can easily change this behavior by changing the prompt. So the system configuration is like we tell the chatbot that it should behave as a healthcare assistant. If you would like it to behave as a retail assistant or anything like that, you just need to change this prompt. The second thing what you need to change is also summarization prompt, because here we are saying you are a healthcare assistant, so you need to summarize the patient to the doctor based on their inputs. If you would like to have a financial assistant, retail assistant, or anything like that, you also need to change that prompt to behave as anything else. Okay, so let's scroll down to the functions. Of course, this kit is open source, as you know, so you can go to our GitHub and, you know, spend as much time as you want reading the code and so on and so on. It should be rather easy. It uses Gradio interface. It uses transformers and Optimum Intel API. So if you're familiar with these libraries, it should be easy for you to understand. The Gradio interface is here, is defined in create UI function, and it consists of a few widgets I will show you in a while. So the main function here is function run. It loads whisper model, it loads chat model, it generates the initial greeting of the patient, then it creates a UI, a user interface, and launch the demo itself. So let's run this application. And I can see that the application is ready. So I am clicking the URL. It's running on my localhost. And as you can see, it's visible here. This is a simple UI. We have a voice widget where we record our voice. Then we have the chatbot responses, and then we have a summarization in the bottom. So let's try to use it for the first time. Let's see how it works. I will start with the prompt that I have: chest pain. I have had chest pain since this morning. Okay, let's see. I am submitting it. Now let's see what the chatbot, the healthcare assistant, is responding. Along with the chest pain, I also have sharp pain radiating towards my left arm, and my body feels very weak. Yeah, it's not bad. There is one mistake. I said pain retreating, but maybe I wasn't clear enough. Let's see if the chatbot can understand that and can answer. Even if the translation wasn't, you know, fully correct, now it understood that the pain is radiating. We could continue this conversation saying that I feel something else, or maybe it's not so serious as I thought, or anything like that. But let's try also summarization. So now I am clicking summarize button. So it means that this healthcare assistant will be summarizing the patient's conditions to their doctor right now. So this summarization shouldn't go to the user. Of course, this is just a simple interface, so it will appear on the screen, right? But this summarization should go directly to the doctor. I'm just running on my simple laptop. This is 2 years old laptop. So I think 30 seconds to get the full summarization is super, super nice. Of course, if you need better performance, you can go with some server, like for example, Xeon server, with some discrete GPUs, and then we'll be faster. But this laptop is absolutely enough to prove that it works and it runs fast enough to test the possibilities of this Edge AI reference kit. Of course, it was a simple case. I just, you know, prompted the chatbot 2 times. We could discuss more. Like, I had been diagnosed with some diseases in the past or anything like that. Then the summary will be more detailed. But of course, I recommend you to try it yourself and see how it works for you. And as I mentioned, this is an example only. It works here as a healthcare assistant. But let's go back to the code and say it again. When you change these prompts, you just need to change these prompts, like system configuration and summarize the customer, maybe also greet the patient. If you would like to greet the customer instead of patient, you can make it working as any assistant. Retail assistant, business assistant, work assistant, working for you, doing for you some job like writing abstracts, writing articles, anything like that. Feel free to try it at home and don't forget to share with us your findings. We also have many other tools and resources engineered to help you build and customize an app that meets your exact needs. Explore our Jupyter Notebooks and GitHub repositories for topics relating to speech recognition, natural language processing, and large language models. Thanks for watching. We invite you to join the discussion on the OpenVINO Toolkit GitHub page, where you can ask questions and share resources and things that you have built. And don't forget to check out the rest of our Edge AI reference kit library for further inspiration.